Next is Above the Clouds. Mm-hmm. Talk about it then.
What do I say about it? Because thank you for helping us in that movie. It was a giant experiment.
You're welcome. A beautiful movie. Proud of you there.
Thank you. Thank you.
And all your other works.
What do I say about it? I mentioned a while ago that Encuentro was probably the best and worst. It was the best because it, of course, puts you on the map, I guess. It's something that I have to put on my CV for the rest of my life. But I couldn't pick up a camera for 2 years after that. I was so afraid of expectations. It's that thing, that rat race of expectations of what other people would say about my second film. Coming from the criticism of the first, I felt like I needed to prove that I could actually make a movie. My own fears. So it was 2 years, I think, of debilitating fear. And then what came out was... Yeah, what came out was a need to please, which I think shows. Although I'm proud of the journey that the film took. It was a... I think in many ways I see it as like a healing production for me, that cost a lot for many people, but a healing production of finding my voice, also getting through the loss of maybe my grandmother. That film got us to work in Paris and spent 3 months mm-hmm. doing post-production. And it's in those 3 months that I really, I think, discovered the kind of filmmaker that I wanted to be in Paris.
No, I like the line, I want to please. I wanted to please.
Yeah, yeah.
I wanted to please. I mean, how does that sound to you, Gino? Your perspective, what does it mean?
Ako naman, you can never please everyone. There'll always be, you know, some will love it, some will hate it, some are in between, but you can't please everyone. I mean...
No, but while that was happening, you didn't have this... internal conversation, you know, you can't please everybody. Mm-hmm. Because when you go through pain like this one, you know, you go to a bathroom and then somebody just says, that film was ugly, or, you know, I was supposed to choose between two films and I'm sorry that I decided to go to yours. I mean, that can break you. You know, that can really break you. That's why I understand mm-hmm. where you're coming from when you said, hindi ako makahawak ng camera dalawang taon. Hindi ko alam. Didn't you have that kind of an experience that somehow gutted you to a certain level na ayaw mong hindi naman.
A 1 year gap. Right?
Gap 1 year
lang. His two films.
Yeah. Yeah. Talaga 1 year. Why?
Ako kasi I was doing so many things.
Not because.
No, parang I would channel myself to something else. I would go to advertising or I would direct something else. Para lang mawala yung negativity or yung mga baggages. I would do a different project.